Alright, hi. This is going to be the first part of my two-part blog post for the week of October 19th, 2012. I'm the teach-up intern at Benjamin Franklin Elementary School Extension in Newlands, Louisiana. My name is Chin. Hi, and welcome. These particular blog posts are going to be about creating digital newsletters, which you can then send out whenever you want to, bi-weekly, monthly, and whenever you feel like you have enough information for that would warrant a newsletter. And the reason why I think this is important is that I think a newsletter, unlike your website, because obviously if you're an intern, you should create a website and to just let people know. But you know, teachers don't always remember the website address. They don't always make it a point to go visit your website for see what you've updated. So newsletter is something that will, it's sent right to their email, so it's something that they can just click on and read, and it will have whatever you want to say, something that new tools, new resources, the activities and the progress that you achieve within that span of time. You can send it to other people, your ISM, whatever parties are you think are would be interested and would benefit. So the first program that we're going to look at is called TinyLetter, and it's tinyletter.com, and it's pretty straightforward. It's for people who just want to log in and just type out the newsletter and just be done with it and just send it out without kind of all the different design options and settings and other kind of the knickknacks that, it's nice if you want to really personalize your newsletter, but if you're not really interested, this is the TinyLetter's the website for you. I'm sorry, I do have to sniffle, so my voice sounds a little strange. I'll be sniffling from time to time. All right, so let's sign up for a TinyLetter account. Ask you for your email, username, and password. Kind of pretty standard. Since I already have an account, I'll just log in. So this is the homepage. Once you log in, the first thing you want to check is your profile information. And this is where you can change your username, your kind of the location information, your real name, address, password. This is also the place where you can change the name or add the name of your newsletter, and as well as a description. And if you add someone kind of manually to your newsletter, this is where you can add a little statement saying why this newsletter is being sent to them. So they don't just get so they don't think that it's just spam, that this is relevant and this is something that you think they should read. So click save. The next is the settings tab. The first thing that you want to look at if you're interested is the help option, which will is pretty useful, and it's divided into topics, so pretty searchable. Next, all the other pages that are kind of related to your newsletter. The first is the subscription page. The subscription link page, actually. And this is first thing you notice is once you that this is going to be your the link to your newsletter. This is where you can kind of design it, and this is where people can subscribe by just entering their email. They can also view the archives and see all the other stuff that you posted in the past. Pretty useful, I think. And here, this is pretty neat as well. This is the embed code. So for those of you who have already created your own website, you can embed this into your website. Many of you are using Weebly. Just open your custom HTML widget and just copy and paste this into there. And it will add a little box that will allow people who visit your website to just subscribe directly from the newsletter directly from your website. Okay. Next is the subscribe page design. This is where you can design what you want your subscription page to look like. They have different backgrounds, background color, and here, since I already have an image, it says remove image background image, but this is where you can upload an image from your desktop, from where you have it saved. I chose this picture of this cat. Different fonts, colors, and other details. And you can go in, as you can see, you can go in and change, you know, whatever you want by just clicking on it. All right. Go back. Now, and this is also, you can change every, like, other pages kind of saying like unsubscribe message, welcome message, confirm subscription message. These are all things that your subscribers will see, will be sent to their emails once they, you know, do the following actions. All right, so once again, we're on the homepage. And obviously, once you have all this set up, you want to compose your first newsletter. And TinyLetter works exactly like an email or, you know, Microsoft Word. Very toned down, simplified Microsoft Word. Here's your subject. You know, you can do whatever you want with it. And here's your the message, and you just type it out. This is my newsletter sample. Hello. And you can keep going like that. You can add links. Oh, you have to scroll over something and add a link. You can add image. You can add lists. You can add headers. Headers are interesting. It just allows you to kind of pick different large fonts that will kind of help differentiate between different sections of your newsletter. Instead of just creating a brand new one, I'll show you one that I made. So this one I made is the first issue of my cat newsletter. So as you can see, this is the one of the headers. You can type it in. I'm using lorem ipsum just because I don't have that much to say about cats. And you can add a picture. You know, it's TinyLetter works. I shouldn't be, I don't know why I'm reiterating this so many times, but TinyLetter acts just like an email message or any of that, except that it allows you to kind of customize it. It allows some customization. It allows you to keep track of all your newsletter. It allows you to send out to huge waves of people. And it also allows people to subscribe to it so that they automatically get it whenever you send it out. So you don't have to constantly, you know, create a newsletter and then type in every single person you want to send it to. It just sends it out. Your contacts. And we're loading. As you can see, I haven't really started creating my actual newsletter yet. I'm not gonna make a newsletter about cats, but this is the only person. And you can add it manually. You can add a CSV file. You can import people from your Gmail account. So it gives you a variety of options to manually add people to your newsletter, or you can just send them the link to your subscription page, and they can subscribe themselves. Okay. I don't know what else to think. And they can also reply to your newsletter. So, and and you can see them all right here. Sent. So yeah, here's my newsletters about cats, and there's a picture of a cat and several cat puns. So yeah, if you want to create a newsletter but don't want to get too involved in it, in the kind of editing and creation detail, TinyLetter is kind of the perfect choice. All right, thank you. And stay tuned for my second blog post in this series, I guess. Thanks.